extremely well-equipped nuclear bunker, where you've decided to spend your final hour on Earth with us, the Durham Revue, watching sketch comedy. A bit of a weird one, guys.
While everyone's out at the big end-of-the-world parties, getting drunk and having a good time, you've come to a student comedy show instead.
You fucking losers.
Well, we've decided this is the perfect format to trial our new material, because if it's shit, no one will ever know about it.
Contrary to popular belief, apocalypses aren't all doom and gloom. Can be quite funny. So we've got a little end-of-the-world themed joke to get you started with. Here goes.
Well, knock knock, who's there? No one, no one's there, everyone's dead, it's the apocalypse. Correct response to that one, I think.
Before we get going with the sketches, we thought we'd run through a few health and safety procedures in case the apocalypse does start during the show.
Firstly, in the event of an apocalypse, this alarm will sound.
This is an apocalypse!
You didn't notice it's actually me and Hamish.
Yeah, that's us.
So if you hear that noise, the apocalypse is only moments away.
Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, are we going to have to repopulate the entire world with only the people in this room?
And I can see you looking at me there, madam. And I know what you're thinking. And the answer's yes.
So as it is our last hour on Earth, we thought we might as well spend it in the comfort of comedy. Mmm, cosy.
This sounds like a mix of noise!
Okay, so this is probably the final time you're going to have to cheer enthusiastically against your will. So let's give it some energy this time, yeah?
This time the room makes some noise!
This time the room makes some noise!
Everyone, make some noise!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to your last hour on Earth.
I hope everyone's brought their HB pencils, because we're going to be doing some silly little sketches.
Like this bad boy.
So, as I call each number forward, please identify the person that stole your purse.
Okay.
Number one.
Oh, no, no, I don't think so.
Number two.
Oh, no.
Number three.
Oh, yes, yes, I think it was him!
Ha ha, yes, get in, woo!
Actually, I think it was probably number one.
Shit. Oh, this little number.
This is amazing!
I know, right?
I can't believe you get to skydive every day!
I don't! This is my first time!
You're not the instructor!
I thought you were!
Oh dear!
Hopefully you'll laugh, and if you don't, I'll probably have another episode!
There may be a few cheeky ones, like this.
Yeah!
There might be a few edgy political ones like this.
A doctor, doctor.
Oh, like... no, just the one doctor today due to NHS budget cuts.
15 love, Boris Johnson.
This is how the whole show's gonna be, by the way. We've got 500 sketches for you kids, so get on fucking board.
Hopefully, there won't be too many like this next one.
Yeah, no, so I really like the idea of female monks. Just gotta come up with a name now, I guess. Any ideas?
None.
And absolutely, categorically, none like this one.
Fire, please. Yes, my house is on fire. My daughter is trapped in there.
Sounds great.
Sorry?
Yeah, sounds amazing.
My house is on fire. Can you please come and put it out?
Oh, no. See, if you wanted the fire putting out, you should have called the Water Brigade.
Well, we've talked about this, okay? Final chance. We're not afraid to recast.
Welcome to the show!
Go Jets!
Yes, go Jets, for we are the Jets from the famed musical, A West Side Story.
Here we are, the East Side boys. These new gangs ain't gonna know what's in them.
Just you wait, we'll be kings of the East Side in no time.
So, we'll run this city.
You can say that again.
So, we'll run this city.
Yeah, maybe not twice.
You boys seem lost. Kings of the East Side, they say. I'd like to see you try.
Hey, hey, stay back.
Oh my god, I don't know what you do that for!
I'm using weapons!
Wait. Oh, I'm confused. Don't all gangs fight using tightly choreographed musical numbers?
So this is what I thought.
Riff, use your gun. Shoot them back.
This is actually just my fingers and my thumb, boss. I know the mime is quite realistic. Go help Ice. I think he needs immediate medical attention.
Well, I don't know first aid. I only know perfectly executed ensemble pieces.
Hey, pretty boys, do you want to do?
Well, yes, that was the original plan.
Well, I thought you said we were going to roll the east side.
Yeah, we normally sort of do the clicking and the tappy-tap, and it's all fine.
You got a knife on you?
Well, I guess it's this cutting-edge choreography.
It's fine. Donnie will be here any minute, and that guy's hard as nails.
Maria!
Jesus Christ.
Let's lay these jokers to it, boss.
Okay, you call 911. If we get them to the hospital, it'll all be fine.
Or we could just sing about it.
Oh no, that does sound nice.
Nelson, thank God you're still here!
Say the rumors of your resignation aren't true!
You're the best damned vice admiral the British Navy has ever seen! We can't keep fighting without you!
We ran all the way here as soon as we heard the news.
We're on a ship. That really isn't that impressive.
We can't fight at Trafalgar tomorrow without you. We'll be eaten alive, Horatio, please!
I'm sick of all this, you know? The ships, the guns, the ships with guns, and I'm not sure this is what I'm passionate about anymore.
Well, look, what is?
Multi-car insurance!
What?
Yeah, I started this sort of firm on the side a few years back and I don't know, things are looking pretty great for us.
But without your leadership and tactics, we'd never been able to fight the Napoleonic Wars.
Well, I'll actually be fighting a little war myself. On prices, slashing them left, right, and center with Admiral Software comparison software.
Oh my God!
I know, it's pretty spectacular.
But Horatio, the future of the British nation rests on your shoulders. You're one of the global leaders in naval combat.
Speaking of global leaders, best car insurance provider at the Personal Finance Awards.
I'm 5 years running.
Who's counting? Who is counting? Oh wait, I've got it up.
Okay, this is simply ridiculous. Alexander lost his arm at Cadiz last week.
Sorry, forgot about that.
And all you can talk about is bloody car insurance.
Lost and all. How about losing half your car insurance bill and saving up to £345 on average per annum?
What?
Glad you asked. With Admiral Multicover, you can bundle your car and home insurance on one single policy, even if they have different renewal dates. I mean, what?
Men, I have grave news. Officer Cook has fallen overboard and drowned.
Oh my God.
That is dreadful, isn't it? With Admiral Life Insurance.
Right, that's it!
Some facts out of a boring old book. We let you get on with some fun group work instead.
Miss, you can't be serious. Can't you tell them to stop?
Come on, we're not savages. Teaching isn't just about telling people off anymore. It's about making a difference and sharing ideas. Teamwork makes the dream work.
Miss, they're trying to kill me!
I love how interactive we are. We're really engaging with the topic in an unconventional way. Why don't we have a thought shower about how we can take this further? Sam?
I'm going to slit his throat and drink his blood!
Yeah!
That is a great idea. Why do you write that on a sticky
note and put it on the palm tree over there.
I say we chop his arms off and sacrifice his mutilated corpse to the sun god! Yes!
There is no such thing as a wrong answer.
Miss, I can't breathe!
Never say I can't. Always say I'll try. Anyway, looks like you're getting on fine without me. I'm just gonna head off and search for some fresh water back in about half hour or so. There might be a few gold stars if you're lucky.
Oh!
Keep it up, guys! Oh! And by the way,
welcome back to First Dates. On this week's episode, let's check back in with Julie, who seems to be having a really good time on her blind date.
Anyway, I'm blabbering. What is it you do? Hello? Peter? Peter? Peter?
God, this lamb is lovely, David. Thanks so much.
Oh, thanks, Jane.
Such a great idea to get all us neighbours together. Why haven't we done this sooner?
I know.
James, what is it you do again?
Well, I'm not a spy. Ha ha!
No, right. So what do you do?
What is it I do now? You know when you do it the whole time and it just pops out of your mouth. You haven't said anything in a while, Barbara. Why don't you chirp up your moody cow? What? No, you're sweating!
Have you forgotten your job?
What's it you do, Julie?
I'm a civil engineer.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Really?
Yeah, just remembered. Love me some civil engineering, always working on that.
Well, which firm do you work for?
I'm between jobs.
Oh, well, if you give me your number, I'll be sure to put you in contact with my boss.
Yeah, sure. It's 007-07-821-901-496.
I'll just give it a ring so you can save the number.
No, please don't!
I'm not a spy.
Is that your ringtone?
What ringtone? I can hear anything.
Right. Should we move on to dessert?
Yes, and James, James, what is
it? It's not a gun, it's an erection!
Right.
We've got you now, Bond! Any final words?
Yeah, David. Your lamb tastes like shit.
Oh.
To find you, you have to help us.
Well, what is it?
Oh, the white witch, her wicked ways. She makes it so it's always winter, but never Christmas.
I know. What's the problem?
No Christmas!
The horror!
The sacrilege!
How do you cope?
Well, we're all Jewish.
What?
Well, the Beavers are Buddhist, but I think it's just a phase.
You're all Jewish. I don't understand.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're speaking to a talking lion in a kingdom located inside a fucking war truck. Suddenly you find out we're celebrating Yom Kippur and all hell breaks loose.
But we met Santa.
Yeah!
God, that man that keeps giving weapons to children. I really ought to do something.
I guess it does kind of make sense.
I mean, think about it. Have you ever seen Mr. Thomas's foreskin?
No. Don't answer that!
And if you look closely, this is Narnia is actually an anagram for we're all Jewish.
Is it?
No.
Shalom, Aslan.
Shalom. The army is ready and the stage is set. We go to battle with the White Witch tomorrow morn.
Oh, tomorrow? Best not.
What's the... Of course, the Sabbath.
Yes.
Introducing Prince Africa, the new fragrance for man.
What's the, right, you're lovely, it's just, sorry, I think there's been a bit of a misunderstanding.
Prince Africa, not for gays.
Mummy's angry.
No, darling. I'm not angry. I'm just really fucked off. Do you actually have no idea what's going on?
Oh, cheer up, Mum. It's Christmas.
Cheer up. Cheer up. I came down this morning, slippers on, eggnog in hand, to find Santa had left nothing. Again.
Mum, I think there's something you need to know.
Then I've let it slide over years. I've actually had enough. Have I really raised you that badly?
He's not real.
What?
Santa isn't real. They made him up for kids.
Ben, I did not spend 80 grand widening the chimney for you to make jokes with me. But he must be real. I met him at the shopping centre with his elves. I sat on his lap.
It was just a man in a suit.
But what about the documentary we watched?
Mum, the Grinch isn't a documentary.
So it was all pointless. All the letters I've written him, all the hours I've spent searching for his house in the North Pole on Google Maps. Nothing but ice. My whole life has been a lie.
Don't worry, Mummy, we still love you.
I'm packing it, you stupid bitch. He's making a list.
Mum, please.
He's checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town.
This is why Dad left, isn't it?
Mr. and Mrs. Parrot, thank you for coming into the station.
So you understand you've lost your child?
We have no idea who took our boy, officer. Just please, God, bring him back to us. We miss him so much.
Stay strong for our lad. We just want to know where he is and to have him back. We love him so, so much.
Don't worry, we've got the best people on the case. Our artist has drawn up a sketch based on the description you gave us. Is this your child?
Yes, yes, that's him, our beloved Walter.
Now, where did you see him last?
Well, the last time we saw him was at the circus. Yes. I thought I'd seen him over by the elephants, but it was just a dog in a shirt, hat and glasses.
Easy mistake to make.
Mr. Parent, our report suggests this is not the first time you've lost your child.
Hey! Those were all accidents. I mean, we lost him one time at that big awards ceremony, but we found him straight away. He was just hiding behind a big stripy curtain.
Can't believe we didn't spot that boy earlier.
Is it true that you regularly take your son on hugely risky days out, losing him every single time?
Hey, what cool parents haven't lost their children multiple times in several different discreet locations?
Right, says here you've taken him to a pirate ship, to the bottom of the sea with minimal scuba equipment.
Good day, good day.
To the moon.
And you took him to Portugal on holiday and you left him in that hotel room.
Whoa! That's a very different case.
This is ridiculous. We just want the best for our child. Yeah. We take him to the most exotic places we can afford. In other words, the moon.
The moon!
How did you lose him on the moon?
There were thousands of people there.
Well, it was a bank holiday.
True, yeah.
Besides, I've seen that hat you make him wear. Sure he didn't run away out of embarrassment?
He loves that hat! It was very much in vogue at time of purchase. All right.
Sarge! Sarge! I found him! I found him!
Close enough.
Seamless.
Churchill, the people of Britain are worried.
We're under great threat from the Nazis, Winston. We need your guidance.
Families everywhere are relying on you.
And we must fight for a better home for our children.
How could you just sit there in silence?
I've got a really good feeling about this car insurance thing.
You can't be serious.
Oh, yes.
So we've had a lot of fun tonight. As it is our last hour on Earth, we think it's only right to remember the friends, family, and loved ones that didn't make it this far and couldn't be with us this evening. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, guys.
It's been what? 10 years.
Wow. As many as 10.
Time flies, doesn't it?
Oh, Pete, I nearly forgot to ask, how's the new job going?
Yes,
really good, actually.
Thank you. What is it you're doing again?
You know, business talk. I don't want to bore you guys.
Oh, he's just being modest. Yeah, come on,
tell him. What is it?
All right. I'm a merman.
Oh. Very impressive.
I just found my previous job so restrictive, you know. And in fairness, it has done wonders for my lifestyle.
What was it you were doing before?
Corporate law.
Oh, yes.
Just felt like the obvious career switch, really. And once I got the qualifications, Frosty Swim Badges levels 1 to 10, I thought, what the bloody hell?
Must be quite different, though. Quite different being a mermaid.
Merman?
Oh, touching.
Thank you. Does have its downsides, I suppose. Do miss the legs from time to time, the old pinaroos.
I used to.
But,
Jeremy.
Oh, I'm sorry, I did.
Sorry about that, guys.
No, don't worry. Happens to the best of us.
Also, the genitals.
Sure.
I'm feeling the absence of those quite strongly now. But then again, we weren't planning on having another child after our Felix, because, as you know, he's a twat.
Oh, he's awesome.
And Helen won't touch me now that I'm part fish, so I've got a real need for them, actually.
You know, I found as I've gotten older, actually, as a general rule, the higher percentage fish your DNA, the less women want to sleep with you.
It's interesting.
Yeah, it's the smell.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah, it does have its perks, though. Been on some great conference weekends. I've seen the sea wall, the coral reef, the city of Atlantis. Or did I? Shh.
And sitting like that must do wonders for your core.
Yeah, it's really difficult.
you got really good at it by now. So.
Yeah,
great,
yeah. Yeah, but only on one side.
Yeah. Yeah,
I've got an excellent view from here, honestly.
Oh, cheers, mate. Yeah.
I see, it's so lean now. Like, you weren't fat before.
No. Yeah, cheers. That's it's
complex. Transformation.
Yeah,
get
cheers.
Back to the script, or?
Yeah, maybe. Oh, and boys, the sirens.
Oh, yeah!
Fucking terrifying, really evil creatures.
Yeah.
Actually, Pete, we're about to pop out and get some dinner. I'm not sure if you're able to, or...
Absolutely. Where's close?
Oh, there's an Italian. Oh, and that lovely Chinese.
A fish and chips.
Welcome back to this extraordinary episode of Deal or No Deal, where I'm here with Jackie from Basingstoke, who has just the £50,000 and £250,000 boxes left. So, Jackie, you've got a choice to make. Box number 3 or box number 12?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, hang on a second, Jackie. Looks like the bank is prepared to offer you one last deal. What? Really? All right, mate, calm down. So he says that your previous offer of £80,000 is now off the table, but he has a new proposition. He's now offering you no money and no chance to open another box because he's got both your kids.
What?
Deal or no deal, Jackie?
No deal, no deal!
And that's all we've got time for on this episode of Deal or No Deal. Join us next week to hear Alan from Peterborough, believe it, that his dog's being skinned. Woo!
At the Chichester Literary Festival, we have a very special guest reading an extract from his new autobiography. Please put your hands together for Nunu from the Teletubbies. Woo!
Right, I might as well get this out of the way to begin with, since this is all the fans seem to ask me for these days. Here's the catchphrase. Chapter 6. Things had taken a turn for the worse. The ratings were dropping, our audience was still predominantly babies, And Dipsy was thinking about leaving the show. I spoke to him backstage a few days before we were pulled off the air. He turned to me, and with an air of dejected melancholy, he said to me, Dipsy bored of 6 a.m. slot on CBeebies! Dipsy went to RADA! Dipsy want to do Hamlet! He'd had an audition with the RSC that morning, but it was the same old story. They said the giant television screen in his stomach made him incompatible for the part of Rosencrantz. The whole cast was unhappy, and I was no exception. The Mirror had just published an exclusive on my addiction to tubby custard. I was snorting the stuff practically daily at that stage, and looking back on it, it was almost certainly illegal for the producers to force me to slurp it all up. I used to think the show was a bit shit, to be honest with you, watching those four bundle around saying, uh-oh, for 20 minutes. But when I was high, it was fucking awesome. Yeah. Things were falling apart, all right. And the nail in the coffin came when Tinky Winky was fired. You remember that handbag he used to carry with him at all times? Turns out he was harbouring a small child in that bag. What can I say? It was the BBC. These things happened, all right? Just had to get on with our lives. I did a lot of travelling in Southeast Asia. My career was down the pan, my social life in tatters. Nothing a few ladyboys couldn't sort out. Yeah, the glory days may well have been over, but I was still the Nunu. And I knew, knew, that the best was yet to come.
Sugar helps the medicine go down.
Do-do-do. Did you not tell her Michael was diabetic?
So we thought we'd have a break from the silly little sketches after that last one. No one's come to a comedy show and just laughed.
Ooh, ha ha!
Look at the funny boys!
No, what you also want to do is
cry.
Learn. What we used back there was a classic comedic tool, the pullback and reveal. Oh, hi there, guys.
This is where we take the audience's expectation, thank you, and have a little play.
And what you thought originally was just a child who didn't really get on with Mary Poppins was, in fact, a diabetic.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
And the correct response was, in fact, So we thought it'd be fun to go for a few examples with everyone here today, and then hopefully we can all take something away from today's show.
Here's the first one.
Transition.
Could we pull over, please, mate?
What? No!
It's just, I'd really like a cigarette.
Well, you'll have to wait until we get there then.
It's fine, I'll just crack a window.
No!
Why not?
You know why! This is your captain speaking. Transition!
So there, what you initially thought was a man trying to get a car to pull over, was in fact
a smoker! A dirty, filthy smoker!
Again, we took your expectations, thank you. Now a little play.
Try this next one on for size. Transition!
Mate, last night was bloody mental. They were playing banger after banger, the vino was flowing. At one point in the night, get this, guy comes over, pops a tab in my mouth. I mean, I don't usually do drugs, but
Have you really never been to Comedian before? Transition! Now there, what you originally thought was just a man recounting a big night on the stairs, a few pills, a few bevvies. You guys know what I'm talking about.
Was in fact the Pope.
The Pope. It was Pope Francis.
The big man.
The big boy.
Again, we took your expectations. We had a little play.
And finally, transition. Transition. Now here, what appears to be just two regular friends hanging out is actually
the physical demonstration of the relative densities of oil and water.
So, that's all for lesson one. I hope everyone has learnt something from that. I know I certainly have.
I never want to learn anything again in my life.
And now for lesson two, punchlines.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for some spellbindingly sexy action? Lose those layers, cause it's getting hot, hot, hot in here tonight. For one night only, we bring you the man, the myth, the legend, Magic Mike!
Thanks so much for stepping in last minute. Can't tell you how much of a help it's been. Don't be nervous. Don't be nervous there. You're going to be great.
You're on 5, 4.
Good evening, and welcome back to the Yesterday Channel. Now, there's no two ways about it, I'm afraid. We've simply run out of old Nazi footage to show you. Tonight, we present to you instead a dramatisation of the First Crusade. Written by me in the space of about 15 minutes. Now, unfortunately, our usual sound manager was unable to make it to the studio at such short notice. But thankfully, two brave interns. Sorry, what were your names?
George.
George.
Shay.
All right, whatever. George. George and Shay have valiantly volunteered to provide all the sound effects for tonight's performance. Thanks, guys. Let's give them a massive round of applause. The year is 1098, and the Christian armies of Europe are preparing for a holy war against the Islamic kingdoms in the east. Pope Urban II enters the city of Clermont to glorious fanfare!
Boom.
Trumpets need a bit of work by the sound of things, but... where he declares the will of God to return Christendom to the land of Canaan. As the Crusaders march towards the Orient, thousands of peasants line the route, offering words of encouragement, such as...
Let's go.
Conquering the Holy Land, it's not their GCSE. Up high, loud crows circled above the travelling warriors.
Go, go, go!
Bang on, mate, brilliant. And every citadel and monastery in Europe was filled with the sound of monks singing Gregorian chants. Admittedly quite good, to be fair. Finally, they arrive at the city of Antioch, where Stephen of Blois is tasked with launching the first assault on the Islamic territories. He mounts his trusty stallion, gallops across the arid desert, and plunges his lance into the heart of a screaming infidel! And he hits some of the crows on the way by the sides of things. They continue on to Jerusalem, and they arrive on the 13th of July, which is coincidentally Alan Hansen's birthday. Genuinely. I had to research all of this. Yeah, so. Do you know who he is?
He's, yeah.
Doesn't match the day. Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Didn't laugh, that's all. You all right?
Yeah.
The city is ransacked, and after its destruction, there remained but one sound in the air. It was the sound of lost innocence, the sound of failed dreams and broken promises, the sound of a doomed generation and an unprecedented scale of loss and suffering. Yes, it was all of those abstract concepts rolled into one sound, which the Crusaders proceeded to hear.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Yeah, slightly underwhelming on the last one, if I'm being honest, but I think it was a very good effort on the whole. Let's give a massive round of applause. There were some other crusades, but I couldn't be bothered to Google them. So that's all the original content for this week. Join us after the break for another episode of World War II in colour. Good night!
gong. And may I be the first to welcome you all to Hogwarts. It is no time for you all to be subject into your houses by the sorting hat. So, when I read out your name, will you please come forward to be sorted? Harry Potter!
Oh, chosen again.
Difficult, very difficult. Plenty of courage, I see. Not a bad mind either. There's talent. Oh, yes. And first, to prove yourself. But where to put you?
Not Slytherin, not Slytherin.
Not Slytherin, eh?
Sorry, who the fuck do you think you're talking to? I've been doing this job since before you were born, but no, it's great advice from you, an 11-year-old child.
Sorting.
No, it's just sort of funny that you think you're in any position to critique my process. off you've been Hogwarts, what, like 5 minutes? And I've been here hundreds of years, so... you see nearly headless Nick over there? Hey! Ooh, to me, he's just Nick. But it's fine. Actually, it's not fine! You think you're so cool because you've got your little lightning bolt scar. We've all got scars, mate. Even if they are emotional. Yeah, that's right. Not jumping up now, are we? Yes, Becky, four-eyed prick! You know, if I wasn't a hat, and I had arms and legs, I would fuck you up. You know what, you think this job's so easy, you do it. Albus, get me down!
Oh,
get me up! All right, next man, go on. In, go! Go on then, mate. Up you get.
What?
Good. Now, what house? I'm sure we'd all love to know.
Don't you even think about it.
Hufflepuff?
Wrong. Muggleborn Half-Blood with a thirst for improvement and a natural flair for problem solving. Blighted Gryffindor. Next.
Sorting, if you do not put Mr. Potter into his house right now, you'll be out of this castle sooner than you can say Quidditch.
Fine. Slytherin.
Well, that was the last sketch, and unfortunately we're all going to die now.
Yeah.
That's still happening, sorry. Yeah.
But we thought it'd be fun to think about how we would have spent our final hour if we hadn't been performing for you guys.
I think I would have gone to see my girlfriend. The world is ending. Armageddon, son. Cheers, guys.
Guys, do you think they know?
Know what?
Do you want me to tell them?
You've been pranked, you fool!
Oh, you should have seen your faces. Oh no, the world's gonna end.
Say goodbye to the ones I love!
£5 for bunker entry! Not in this economy.
No, sure.
But seriously, madam, I'll still be outside afterwards. They've never winked back before.
I'm gonna say the boyfriend seems keen.
We do have fun.
But that seriously is the end of the show. I hope you all had a good time.
And if you've got any friends you want to see you get totally punked, then I'll bring them along to our next show.
Only gullible losers allowed.
thank you so, so much for coming to see the show. If you haven't seen us before, give us a follow on social media. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, at the Durham Revue to stay updated.
And we'll be having our next show with a new troupe at the beginning of next term.
No, Michael, we told them it was a joke. You don't need to do that anymore.
Michael?